गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. टुडे आई हैव डिसाइडेड टू डिस्कस अ वेरी यूनिक टॉपिक, एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्री अंडर द कोर्स ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर मार्केटिंग ट्रेड प्राइस इन बीएससी एग्रीकल्चर. सो लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर कोर्स इज दैट वील नो दैट वाट काइंड ऑफ दैट एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्रीज आर देयर. And it is going to help you out while if you have plan to start any startup in agriculture sector. So let us have a discussion on that. Agro-based industries are those industries which depend on agricultural products as a raw material. For example, textile industry or any agro-based the fruit production, the fruit juice company, or sometimes the horticultural product based like the ketchup or sauce or like that, or rice industry, dal industry, sometimes the flour industry. So all these, they are the industry based, or all the food ingredient based industries, just like the noodles or like that, a potato chip factory or like that. All these they are the agro-based industry. So it means the agro-based industries are those industries, those who are using the whom are using the agricultural product, agricultural produce as a raw material to prepare their furnished product. Now the meaning of agro-based industry and constraint of agro-based industry and suggestions. These are the three topics. These are the sub three topics under which we'll discuss the entire topic of agro-based industry and its importance in our country. Meaning of agro-based industry. Let us have first that thing. Agro-based industries are comparatively easy to establish and provide income in the rural area with less investment. It means these are the industry through which we can have opportunity to provide a huge number of people employment in the area, because we know that the agricultural produce they are available in the rural area. So if we establish these kind of industries in that area, that we can not only provide the employment, but it can be easily established over there, because they are having the raw material of these product, which is these companies, those who are being required, can be supplied by the agricultural that production which is generally in the area for in which we have decided to establish agro-based industry of that particular commodity. And one far more interesting thing is that if connectivity, road connectivity is proper, then we can accommodate the skilled labor, and the other unskilled labor is also available at a very lucrative rate. So this is also the very important that thing which is very important, that agro-based industries are comparatively easy to establish and provide income in the rural area with less investment. That is the ideal part of that agro-based industry. These industries facilitate effective and efficient utilization of agricultural raw material. Yes, this is very important, that these industries, the wastage of agricultural, that sometimes the few things they are not in the for example, we have a parali that issue in Punjab and Haryana. So we can use this raw material of which is waste, and the farmers, they are burning that raw material that the husk and the parali of the rice production after the rice taking. This was a very very big issue, and it creates a problem. It pollute, not only pollute the environment, but also because of the burning, and the farmers, they don't have any options, because they so now the government has started that we procure this parali, and we will prepare the manure from out of it, and sometimes the parali can also be used for preparing of biodiesel. So these are kind of that industry which we can easily establish in the area where we have this kind of that raw material which is creating problem in the society. So we utilize that kind of thing in our interest. So these industries facilitate effective and efficient utilization of agricultural raw material. That is a decent example of this thing. Then agro-based industry transmit an industrial culture in rural area. Yes, if we start any industry in the rural area, definitely the thought process of entire that rural mass enhanced. And there are certain social circumstances because of the introduction of the people over there. Some people definitely the technocrats or will hire from somewhere else. But the new normal that the employment to be given to the area, the people of the area. So definitely when they came into the interaction of the other people, and sometimes they see the level of their thinking and all the things. In overall, if you see that the not only they transmit the technical skills to the people, but also they cultural and rural that things, sometimes the traditional, those barriers, they are there. So we can remove these barriers through establishment of these agro-based industry in the area where they are being required because of the ample amount of raw material for these industries available. Then the some of the agro-based industries like processed food and food preparations have tremendous export potential. Yes, we see that we know the potato chips or like that, the pizza, burger. This industry can easily be established in the area where we know that the entire that the food grains is available over there. So we can utilize the resource of the agricultural that produce, and they can have the opportunity to, sometimes we know that the maize is also being the American maize or like that, the sweet corn or these are the few companies, those who can have directly the maize production in the area where is the cultivation of cultivate production practices of maize in a huge amount. We can establish these kind of company over there, and then because the raw material that will be bought from the purchase from the farmers itself, so we can have that kind of that can have the financial health of not only the farmers of the area, but if the income goes to the farmer, ultimately it will come to the industry. Because when the standard of for enhancement of standard of living, definitely they'll go to purchase for several other that the utensils and several other the equipments, several other those things. So the output of the industry, for example, TV, fridge, like that. These are the examples that if the standard of the people goes in upward direction, or if their income is increased like that, then definitely they spend their money on these kind of the vehicles also. So all these things, sometimes machinery they'll hire, and they'll put that machinery in their for their home for their domestic use. So this, through this, we can uplift the overall that GDP of the country and the economic health of the country or the state or the region we can enhance. So we can have opportunity to establish these kind of industry in the area where they have a tremendous potential to provide the raw material which is the primary requirement of the industry. And not only the raw material, also the unemployment problem and the problem, the urbanization which is going on day to day in increasing order, that can be prevented by engaging people in the area from where they are. Agro-based industry can be set up on cooperative basis, ensuring participation of the people in the development process. Yes, this is a very good idea. That means see the good example of this cooperation we have observed and tested, and now it was truly that we have achieved U-turn in as far as the milk production is concerned, because this cooperative concept was introduced in 1965 64 when it was discussed with the Dr. Varghese Kurien by the late Prime Minister Mr. Shastri, and then the Operation Flood was born. And because that entire concept of Operation Flood was just on the basis of the woman, that milk society, those who are being created at village level, the entire milk procurement being taken up by the society, and it was to be given to the dairy unit of that area. And then we know that the Khera district, this was a prime example of this kind of that thing which is already being done in the country, and we have got the success. So that kind of that concept further we can use in the agro-based industry. And we can because the farmers in our country, they are having the small holding. They are having the small holding. 75% of farmers, as we know, that they are having less than 2 to 3 acre land. So in that case, if the cooperative initiated among them, then they will start the producing the agricultural product as per the need of the industry, those who are being set right in their area. So that kind of thing, that the win-win position for both of them. Through cooperation, they start doing the crops and the fruits or like the vegetables. So those who are the primary requirement of the industry, and that will be give up them the them the improve the financial health, and they can also utilize the all new techniques, those who are available in those who are developed, and through the research and development in agricultural sector. Only if they have the cooperative, because cooperative system at the ground level for producing the crops and vegetables, fruits, etc. Because through this they can have a society under certain that rules. They registered, and they surrender their entire land to the society, and they started doing the business, doing the agriculture on the basis of the consensus they have in the society. So on the basis of that can have they can help the not only they can help the country, but they can help themselves first. And then through this we can have opportunity to enhance the economic and the economic development and growth of the area and the country by and large. So now, constraint of agro-based industry. What are the problems those they are there? If somebody is wanted to start this kind of concept of agro-based industry, there are definitely, it's not an easy way. It's not a walk. It's not a morning walk into it's not just a walking in jogging or like that, joggers park, because it's definitely consensus among the people at rural mass, because they have the traditional that sometimes the traditional enmity with each other. Sometimes they have the differences of opinion, sometimes they have the caste barrier, the religion barrier sometimes. So these are the few important things, and that definitely the financial status of the different set of the people in the society of rural mass, that is also one. Because zamindars, they don't want to sit with the poor people, poor farmers. So these kind of that mindset we have built a consensus among them, that how democratically we can achieve the big that goal through the small objectives those we have designed to achieve the final destination of growth and development and upliftment of the society at large. So there are some number of that the constraint and the problems those who are identified by the economist and the several that agriculturists also. Let us have a discussion on them one by one. The concern for backward area development overshadowed the efficiency of consideration and the resolved policy for industrial dispersal, which creates sick units. Agglomeration has a logic of its own, and the industrial location policy has to keep this dynamism in view. So the first that it's very difficult that the concern for backward area development overshadowed the efficiency consideration. That is the prime reason, that because the efficiency in the because they are not having that much of technical know-how, and they are following the things as they have in their traditional that manner, and from which they have received from their ancestors traditionally. So it's very difficult sometimes. That's why the industries, those who are in the business, they are least interested to invest in the area and in the area of agro-based industry in the particular the rural area, because they feel that their finance is insecure. So in that case, how we can counsel them, and in what way the government can give the incentives to them? There are certain state government, they are giving the incentives to the owners of these industries, those who are interested, because this is a thing in the which can alter the entire economic that scenario of the country. So that's why the startups in the agro on the agro-based industries, they are prime requirement of the day. And this is a solution of so many problems. They'll arise if you'll not follow this kind of policies. So agglomeration has a logic of its own, and industrial location policy has to keep this dynamism in view. Yes, if that I have already communicated that the government and the state, they have to build a policy like that. They have to generate the strategy through the policies that they can give more incentives. They can give so many waivers to these industries. So at least they feel that the until and unless the industrialist or the person who want to have a startup in the rural area, at least first he feels secured that his finance, whatever the investment he had made, that will be definitely giving him, that will be go to give him benefits in future. So that kind of that security, if will be imparted in the mind of the people, those who are interested in startup, and further the government can give the financial assistance, lucrative interest rate loan, and all these things. For that the government of the day, they are doing this thing, because in the pandemic era, we know that the small industry and small that the farmers, they affected lot, because they have a limited capital, and if the exchange of that capital is not in process because of the pandemic, because of the lockdown or like that, so they cannot afford such type of the financial crisis for a longer period of time, such as the big giants. They can afford it, but the small, that's why the government, they have started giving loan to them, and the millions of rupees they have allocated under this segment. So that is an important thing which is required, and the dynamism of the policy is also required. Then second, B, absence of information. The absence of information, lack of awareness about the opportunities, and limited knowledge about the technology and production system is a major entry barrier for rural entrepreneurs. Yes, this is because they are the people, they have the less skills and the potential. Less skills only, they are having the huge potential, but because of the unawareness, because of the lack of the information, so that's why the government should establish the government has already established the experts team, those who are experts in entrepreneurships, and how they can have start these all these things. If they impart these technical knowledge and information to the rural people, those who are interested in establishing the agro-based industry, but because of that lack of awareness, lack of information, they are just not thinking. In their thought process, this thing was not there. So in that case, what they had to do? They have to just look at that how they can have this kind of thing with them. So we see that the absence of information, lack of awareness about the opportunities, and limited knowledge about technology and production system is a major entry barrier for rural entrepreneurs. Yes, this thing we have discussed. If so, that's why the government, they have started the ITIs at industrial training institutes and other training, that polytechnics, and also these kind of the institution, those who are being started at the ground level, to uplift the technical knowledge of the people. And the courses among these technical institutes, they are just as per the need of the people. So that's why nowadays we have a skills development program at ground level, to have a startup to give the initiatives to the rural people, rural entrepreneurs. They can start the small unit of agro industry at their own. After that, when they have well equipped from knowledge point of view. The productivity of rural labor is conditioned by the rural culture, the available skills and training, and capacity intensity of the projects. Under the prevailing conditions, the productivity of rural labor is low and the marginal lower wage rate in rural area do not compensate for this low productivity. Under the circumstances, the subsidies and the incentives on capital investment have promoted intensity even in agro industry and has had a detrimental impact on labor intensive manufacturing. So that is also the because they are not skilled, so their efficiency and productivity is adversely not like that which we expect from the trained people. So for that is we are starting now, that there is already the program which is being launched by the Prime Minister of India, skill development is for small startups, what kind of that skills and talent is required, that to be imparted by the technocrats, and it is going to help the people of the rural area, that how they can have they can enhance their efficiency, because if they are being trained, then the working efficiency, the production capacity of the unit, they can enhance like up to the any level which is desirable in designing the that kind of that industry in the rural area. So that the investment and the returns, it's ultimately the important key factor of the business. So if the efficiency of labor enhances, automatically the productivity enhances, and the productivity enhances, then definitely the outcome enhances, and the outcome enhances, it means the cost of production declines like anything, and ultimately if the cost of production decline, it impacts on the overall profit of the business. So this is the correlated thing, that in what way we can enhance the productivity of the farmers by uplifting their technical knowledge, because traditionally they are so like that, and the cheaper labor is available, but this is not the answer, because if their efficiency is not up to the mark, then even the cheaper labor, even the wages low wages is not a criteria, because if we enhance the productivity, then we also compensate them a reasonable wages which is being designed under the process of the startup. Now the fourth one, it is organizational institutional mechanism that translate the policies and program into reality. Yes, this is the problem at the rural area, because in the urban area we know, or in the still the development area, there is an institution, proper institution is available. The agencies, government agencies are there. They are being support. They are being well supported financially in every state. We are knowing that district development authorities and the state development authorities and the industrial development authorities. These are the authorities. When you submit your project to them regarding any industry, they arrange the land and all the initial that amenities like electricity, water, connectivity, that kind of infrastructure is being developed by the industry. So but in the rural area we don't have that kind of opportunity, because that to be looked after. If we are having that thing, then it's very easy for us to have a agro based industry in that area. So it is organizational institutional mechanism that translates the policy. Yes. So we have to build this kind of that agency. Now we are having through the certain that development program which we are having through panchayats and through gram panchayats, but we require the mass of the technical know-how people. What can be done in their area, and what kind of that arrangements to be given by the government and the state authority and the district authority for the area where the agro industry is required. Unfortunately, the rural entrepreneurs is left out without support system of any significance. That we have still, we are still struggling on this part of the very important part of the industrial development in the rural area. Then the fifth one, investment in agriculture sectors are aimed primarily towards providing wage goods, the urban industrial sector. The investment in agriculture sector was aimed primarily towards providing wage goods to the urban industry. So this is the interesting thing, that we are investing in the agriculture area only to provide the raw material to the urban industries. This is the phenomena we have to revert. We have to prove. Yes, of course, we have to uplift the agricultural production, productivity of farmers by this way or that way. That either through the cooperation or through the scientific, that new techniques they imparted, and only they can use those techniques, and they can enhance the per hectare productivity per animal productivity, like that. But this we have to think, we have to shift that industrial mindset which is cited in the urban area to the rural area. So that kind of reverse conditions only we can have, only if we develop the agency which can deliver the industrial development, which can deliver, and not only deliver, which can give the insurance, we can assure through that agency that the investment in the rural area by any industrial will, and any industries in the industrial entrepreneur will be safe and secure and will be profitable for them. So that kind of that thing which is missing in the agriculture. So let us have once again relook on that the investment in agriculture sector was aimed primarily towards providing wage goods for the urban industrial area. Rural employment generation strategy should have taken cognizance of the agro-based industries linkage and paid greater attention to dynamic efficiency in the rural sector. But the policies towards the village and small industry neglected promotion of such industry in rural area by denying dynamic comparative advantage in the rural sector. That is why, you know, we are believing in Mahatma Gandhi, but we are not following the idea of Mahatma Gandhi. This is because Gandhi ji has said the development can be if the smile on the last, that the poorer of the society is there. So if we are right now, we are after even 72 years of the independence, we miserably failed, all governments failed. So now we have to relook on that policy, how we can uplift the, until unless we not provide the employment and employment opportunity, and we will not self-reliance the rural mass, till then we will not achieve the real sense of the independence, those dreams to be taken into the consideration by the freedom fighters when they fought our battle of freedom struggle. That policy bias against the wage employment was further accentuated by the instance on the promoting self-employment in development program. Yes, this is also the discrimination in salaries, wages are also, we'll see, even the government is having the labor department and there are so many things, but ultimately these corrupt people, they destroy the entire structure. Because what everywhere the discrimination, we'll see, even in the city area, we'll see that the discrimination at large, district level, we'll see, in any industry, we'll see that the entrepreneurs, they are discriminating the labor, they are discriminating the people, those who are because of that the unemployment the scenario, they feel that they have the right to discriminate and harass the people, those who are financially, economically sometimes, and they are minting money like that, and there is no control over that because they are because of the corruption that CA, they are just transferring this all amounts those they are earning in various sectors, because that loopholes in the system, they are enjoying that thing, and this is the thing which is happening in right now in our democratic society. So let us have a relook on the policy, that the policy bias, that's why we are saying that the policy is biased. And they are always be in the favor of the richer of the society, and we are saying that we are the socialist country, we are the democratic society, but unfortunately these all are the words those who are written in the constitution, but the practically the implementation, when we see, it was nowhere in at the ground level. The richer person, the industrialist, they are not allowing even to enter anybody as those who want to have a dream to start a new entrepreneurship. Because they are the big giants. They are just because of the power, financial power they are having with them, and reserves they are having with them.
So they if in any adverse conditions, they are not allowing the rural entrepreneur into the area where they are like that. Now, no positive efforts was made to involve the rural elite, those who possess capital, human resource to catalyze the development process. Because of that, the lining those we have in the constitution, unfortunately, there is no implementation at ground level. So the industries, those who are sited in the rural areas, they are learning all the government policies this way or that way by influencing the government through the industrial setup which we have in our country. Because through the share market and all these are the things, they are being governed by the people, those who are having the financial impact on this. So unfortunately, the rural entrepreneur, if he is not being protected by the government, then they, and sometimes they are not allowing them into the enter into that forum where he can have we will see only the very few people, those who have developed and those who have grown like anything in those started business startup in the rural area. So no positive efforts was made to involve the rural elite, those who possess capital, human, so to catalyze the development process. This is the drawback of policies, and that's why the problems we see they are there. Suggestions for the development of agro-based industries. This is also very important that how we can have, we have criticized the government. We have in the first one, we have given the benefits and advantage. Then we'll see that the what kind of constraints they are being faced by the society as at a large. Then now we'll see how we can remove these constraints, how we can have that the perfect without leakage policy to enhance this kind of concept, because this is a thing which is required for U-turn as far as the economic growth and the prosperity of the society is concerned. So what are the suggestions? Let us have a discussion one by one. A strategy of development of agro-based industry should consist of the following ingredients. Number one, a growth and expansion of agro-based industry should form an inseparate part of the overall program of economic and industrial development of the country. Yes, we are doing the same that the music we are singing same music. We have established these kind of unit, but they are not functional at ground level. Unless we'll set an industrial setup for rural area only, and that we have to involve the experts, those who are having the area from economic sector, from agricultural sector. They are the authorities being granted to them that how they can have chalk the plan for the person to whom they are being given the charge. So this kind of that kind of setup we have to build at the rural area for the rural area. That strong monitoring is also required that the people are doing, those who are being appointed for the purpose. If the people appointed and they are just enjoying the salary and wages, and because of the government facilities they are also enjoying, but what is happening at the ground? If we will not monitor this thing properly, then unfortunately will that the same thing, because we have agricultural setup at the ground. Unfortunately, we are not succeeding to that much level which we can have. We might be. So that's why we have to appoint the people. We have to appoint the experts. Those who are expert in agriculture, those who are expert in husbandry, those who are experts in fisheries, as per the need and the requirement of the and the geography of the area. And then we'll see that, because already we are having the team, but what kind of that output we are that we are no near of that the objectives and the game goal those we have decided planning for. B, related groups of agro-based industries should set up in coordinated manner so that the utilization of byproduct is simultaneously possible. The agriculture, the production is solely based on the nature and the season, and because we know the kharif, rabi, and these kind of the system we are having in our country. we are not doing the controlled agriculture. In that case, the industry, those who are being set up, how we can provide the raw material to them for all the time throughout the year. So that kind of that coordinated efforts to be required. That in if suppose the one thing is not produced for 4 months in an area this industry is situated, then how we can arrange the raw material for them other area where that kind of product availability or that kind of product is being produced by the farmer. So that kind of thing is also very much required. We have to enhance the cold storage facility. So that when the huge product is there, we can cap that product produce into the cold storage, and then we can utilize that agro-based product in the time and era when the product was not there. So that kind of that arrangement we have to coordinate it. That's why the related group of agro-based industry should be set up in coordinated manner so that the utilization of bio-chain is possible. For example, that the sugar cane industry be set up in the how we can utilize for the production of the various that industrial outputs, various liquor company. Also, because these are the byproducts, those who are being utilized by the liquor company. So we have to set up this kind of this kind of thing is also being utilized in so many other industries of this kind of byproduct, which is a waste product of the sugar industry. So that all the things we have to design while we are for the agro-based industry. Then the new industry, the third one, the new industrial, the new institutional framework must be large number of small farmers to participate and it benefit from agro-processing. The underlying, they need to develop a cooperative network with a view to harmonizing the interest of the producers, processors, consumers, and to avoid excessive dependence on private corporation and multinationals. So because these people, they just only interested in profit. They have nothing to do with the social that upliftment. So we have to develop the Indian our multinationals. That only can address the our social needs along with the profitability. So those both, it's a combination, it is required. Not one way that the only the profit they think and then they whatever what that happen in the case of the Union Carbide, you'll see that these people, they have this was a tragedy, and a lot of people we have lost because of the irregularities and the incompetency of the people of the industry of this pesticide company. So because they have ignored so many situations of that the methyl isocyanide and gas spread into the atmosphere, and because of that we have lost so many people in Bhopal. So and what will happen, because these are the people, they are not making arrangement that how we have a disposal of the industrial waste. Until and unless we not plan all the things at one time, till then have any that the achievement of that, that the final destination or objectives and goal. So these are the things that to be think over it while we harmonizing, and all the interests we have to address at a time when we are designing the policy for the rural area. Now the advanced management and marketing methods should be introduced in agro which cater the export demand. Yes, that is the prime requirement, because we are having so many good unique type of that produce in the agriculture sector, but unfortunately because of that the transportation facility sometimes, because some things those who are being produced at the higher hills of the country, they are expired. So how much we can have the develop the technique to cater these things up to the right user, where we can have opportunity to have a right price for these. So all these things we have to plan, and we have to have a special that sell for that. That how we have advanced management and marketing strategies with us. So that kind of that expert people, we have to build a team, and we have to add that team the policy framing and implementation level. So that only we can achieve through this kind of thing. Now both backward and forward linkage should be ensured in agro-based industry, so the maximum growth impulses are generated. That this is the quite clear. This is correlated. So these all things, and then we'll have a. Now I'll give you the two example through the MCQ that the various agro-based industries below: textile industry, cotton industry, woolen industries, and textile industry, and the synthetic textile industry, jute textile industry, sugar industry, vegetable oil industry, honey, intermediate, sophisticated technology, then the tea industry, then the leather goods industry. So these are the decent, that one, the textile, and then the sugar waste. These are the two examples of the unique nature, that how much we can have opportunity in our country of this kind of that product which I have read through the name of the under the textile industry. We can have textile industry, we can have opportunity to build the woolen textile industry, we can have opportunity to build silk, that you know that the mulberry, from mulberry we can have opportunity to have which is very costly, the silk sarees, we know that how we can have the raw material of these things. This produce only at agriculture level. So that kind of concept we have to float at the ground level. So ultimately and finally, we achieve our objectives of development of that social development. Now we know that we have a NABARD or the regional rural banks or all these kind of that finance. We are also having the rural bank infrastructure we have developed and built and successfully working in our country. But unfortunately, because of the financial that transaction, those who are and under the influence of the influential people, political people, sometimes the industrialists, those who are influencing the entire, and because of the corrupt practices, we are not achieving our objectives and goals. So that is why we have to relook on the things and how we can strictly and effectively implement policies through these financial institutions, those we are having with us. Only we required the reassessment of that, in what way we have done so many things. I'm not saying that all the things that the government is wrong. Sometimes a good if because of the corrupt and the negative mindset of the implementation authorities and agencies, they are building bash at the ground level. So we have to learn this thing, how effectively we can implement the resources those we are having. So these are a few important things, those I have discussed with you thoroughly, and I hope that everybody, those who are in the policy frame, they can have, because we know that the sugar industry, we can establish it in the UP and Maharashtra, because we are having the huge production of western UP and allied area, the farmers, they are based on the sugar cane. So why we establish this in the Maharashtra? Also we have the same situation, the highest yield per hectare we are having in Maharashtra, the highest production of sugar cane we will have in this Uttar Pradesh. So we will the same way can be rice mills in the area of Punjab and Haryana, we have a huge production of this kind of that agricultural product. Then we can establish some types of the textile industry, the silk industry and jute industry, in the area we have this kind of water links in West Bengal, and we'll see that in Bihar also, that we can develop this kind of things in the area where we have a potential of that nature. If we have a potential of that nature, go forward. We will see that sometimes the vegetable based and the fruit based industry we can develop in an area where we have in Himachal, we have so many that the industry, those who are in the manufacturing of that the processed food materials, those who are involved in that. Then we have a coffee industry, then leather industry also being set up in the area where we, for example, in we have Andhra Pradesh, where we have that area where the people, those who are non-vegetarian, in non-veg in a new zone, we can establish this kind of that leather industry over there. They can, and Kanpur also we are having that the traditional leather work, that kind of that we are having. So we can further, we can enhance these kind of things. We'll, after assessing the potential and the geography and the availability of the raw material, that we have discussed thoroughly in this chapter of that the agro-based industry. So I think now I'm closing this chapter, and I hope that you will have a understanding and think throughout that discussion which we have. I have done with you with this positive note. I am just closing the chapter. Thank you very much for participating in the discussion.